Hi everybody, today we're going to take a second look at measures of position. I'm going to add in Desmos to add some easy technology, and we're also going to use Desmos to make box plots. Box plots give a graphical representation of quartiles. When we look at quartiles, we're starting with our smallest data value. When we get to Q1, it's going to have 25% of the data that's less than it. When we get to the median, we have 50% of the data less than Q2. Quartile 3 will have 75% of the data less than that value, and then we get to our largest data value. In the previous video, I showed you how to find the quartiles using the values 10, 15, 20, 22, 27, 32, 35, 40, and 77, but we did this by hand. Today, we're going to go to Desmos and have Desmos do the calculation for us. I like to use lists when I'm doing statistics in Desmos, so I'm going to start by saying A is equal to, and I'm going to type in my numbers 10, 15, 20, 22, 27, 32, 35, 40, and 77. And between data values, I put a comma, and notice that Desmos keeps track of how many elements I have in my list. To get Desmos to tell me the quartiles, I just type in the word stats, S-T-A-T-S, and then I put an A in parentheses. Desmos is case sensitive, so you need to make sure you use a capital A to refer to your capital A list. Immediately, what I see is that the minimum value in our list was 10, the first quartile is 17.5, the median is 27, the third quartile is 37.5, and our maximum value is 77. If you ever forget the command, you can open up the keyboard, go to Functions, and you can see all the commands for statistics. Let's add in a box plot so we can graphically see these values. So I'm going to type box plot. I type an A to tell Desmos what values to use, and then I hit the zoom so that I can see the values. Now, notice out here, I have this little circle over at 77. That says that this is an outlier. If I tell it to exclude outliers, it will extend the bar to go all the way out to 77. So it's really up to the kind of data you're trying to do, whether you choose to exclude outliers or not. If you want to discover whether or not a set of data has an outlier, then you definitely want to checkmark the exclude outliers so that it will indicate the value on your graph. When you click it, it will tell you the value of the outlier. Let's talk about the box plot. In the middle, I have a rectangle. The left side of the rectangle corresponds to Q1, 17.5. The right side of the rectangle is Q3, 37.5, and the line in the middle is our median. Let's try that again with a second set of data values. This time I'll use 12, 18, 33, 78, 92, 112, 215, 257, 299, and 315. Back in Desmos, I typed in the values. This time I called the list B. Now I type stats, put a parenthesis, capital B. So I have a minimum of 12, quartile 1 is 33, median is 102, quartile 3 is 257, and we have a maximum of 315. To visualize that, I type box plot, put in B, and remember to hit zoom. We have it checked to exclude outliers, which means this time there are not any outliers. I don't see any extra numbers drawn anywhere. Quartile 1 is 33. The median is 102, quartile 3 is 257. Sometimes they refer to a box plot as a box of whiskers to show these little lines that extend on each side. On the left side, this extends to the minimum of 12. On the right side, this extends to the maximum of 315. So all of the data is represented by this one visual box plot.